So Aurora just spent over $100 million to secure a stake in a liquor store chain out in Alberta to turn liquor stores into dispensaries. And I'm wondering if you can tell me where that private retail fits into your broader recreational cannabis strategy.
So from the very beginning, we've had the concept of developing Aurora into the most integrated, both vertically and horizontally, the most integrated cannabis company. And we're already involved in everything from the design and engineering of cannabis production facilities through our Aurora Larson Projects division, through to growing and extraction through Radiant Technologies. And this was a logical step for us to take to partner up with Liquor Stores NA for North America, which is the largest private liquor seller in Canada. They were the preferred partner, I think, for every cannabis company, and we're glad that we've managed to bring them into partnership with us. The whole idea there is that we want to be part of creating excellent stores, stores that are attractive to cannabis consumers, that are safe and that have well-trained staff. We want to create the premier cannabis retail stores in Canada, wherever we're allowed to do so.
And is it mostly in Alberta?
At the moment. So Liquor Stores NA is very strong in Alberta. They have something like 200 stores in Alberta. And a number of those will be converted from selling liquor to selling cannabis. There won't be any co-location of alcohol and cannabis in the same stores. So we're looking for really good locations. And we're going to go in there in partnership with liquor stores. They've got all the administration experience, and they know how to run retail stores. We've got the insights and the knowledge with respect to the cannabis consumer. We're going to bring those things together and create a great consumer experience.
So yesterday you guys were one of six companies to secure a supply deal with the SAQ in Quebec. Tell me a little bit about how important that supply deal is and how important provincial supply deals, securing them is going forward.
It's an interesting question. It's a significant amount. It's a minimum of 5,000 kilograms from Aurora. And of course, there's supply coming in from five other companies as well to supply the cannabis retail system in Quebec. This is just the starting point. And I think you'll also find that those contracts will be, you know, based on actual sales. So if your products don't move off the shelves, you're not going to be selling them as much product in the future. We want to make sure that we get SAQ a very good experience. So we're going to give them excellent products. We're starting with dried cannabis. That it's the only thing that's envisioned just yet, but we'll be moving into cannabis oils and additional products as that is allowed by the Canadian federal government. Now, beyond that, we also have some interesting decisions that we have to make as to allocating our product in different provinces in Canada, and also starting with the most important segment of all, and that is our medical patients, which we will not ignore, we will not forget. We've made a very firm commitment that our medical patients in Canada come first, because theirs is a need, not a want. Now, beyond that, we also have our international markets, which are opening up very quickly, and we're selling a significant amount of product in the German medical cannabis system right now, so a significant portion of our revenues are coming from those international sales. And then most recently, just a couple of weeks ago, we won the first of a whole series of tenders, but the first tender in the Italian medical cannabis system to start supplying that system. What we anticipate is that we are going to have to make smart decisions, intelligent decisions with respect to the allocation of our product, whether it be dried cannabis or derivative products, where we use extracted materials, in the medical system, in the Canadian consumer system, and in the international medical system.
How big is the international part of your strategy going forward? I noticed 20% of your total revenue in the last quarter came from sales into Germany. Where does the international game fit into Aurora's overall picture?
The international growth story is the biggest story of all. People's eyes are focused, understandably, on the consumer legalization coming this summer. There are good reasons for that. It's an important thing on a business basis, and it's an important thing to do from a social progress basis. It's the right thing to do in terms of public policy. The bigger commercial opportunity, longer term, will be international. And the reason why is that there are a handful of Canadian companies that have the scale, the experience in cultivation and production, and the access to capital to be the first movers internationally in a whole host of markets that are opening up right now. And we are going to be able to put our stamp, Aurora and Canopy and a few others, are going to be able to put our stamp on those international markets and establish that presence very, very quickly. In essence, it's a little bit like a land grab, and it's one of the reasons why we're moving so quickly. It's why we operate so quickly. It's why we've raised significant capital, and we're deploying it very, very well, very carefully. So the international opportunity is going to be very big, and I don't see any reason why the global cannabis industry industry can't one day, and one day fairly soon, be as big globally as the brewing industry.
Finally, last month, the big news was your guys' billion-dollar hostile takeover turned friendly of CannaMed. I'm wondering where that is now.
It remains friendly, thank God. And if I could just make a little editorial comment here, this is certainly worth it. I'm very glad that it ended up friendly, but if I never go through another hostile takeover again, it'll be too soon. But we are moving together. We're hoping that we're going to be able to close this deal within the next 2-3 weeks. And once that happens, we're going to have one company with a presence in Alberta, in Saskatchewan, in Quebec, in British Columbia with our administrative offices and some customer care and so on, and then spreading across the country with retail wherever it's permitted by provincial governments. And this is a company with Canadian roots. We will always have Canadian roots, but our ambitions are global. So Aurora, together with CannaMed, with all of the technologies, all the skills we have, all the tremendous people that we've got, this will be one big team with a firm eye on becoming the largest and best global cannabis company. It's an ambition that is worth shooting for. We're very, very excited about what's going to be coming in 2018, 2019, 2020.